Hey everyone, I'm Taylor and I'm here at Music Connection today, and we are here to launch my second album, which is titled Light. I'm very excited, can't believe it's come to this, and yeah, check it out.
I wanna be the one for you.
Tell me how it all became. The silly love became all a game. All my hope seems different now.
It was super important for me to release the Dark Horse, but I knew that when I released the Dark Horse, it was important for me to know that the second album will kind of lead out of that album. And so the first record was called The Dark Horse, and the second album is called Light, and it is absolutely, you know, telling that story of being reborn, and I think, like, no matter what career you're in, or, you know, what you do for a living, I think it's so important to expand yourself and push yourself and mold yourself in different ways, and I think, you know, the theme lights also plays on the whole idea of, you know, light is such a positive thing and it's so light, and so I think spiritually it had quite a deep meaning for me.
It all came, the city love came again.
So the shift really came quite dramatically from the first record into the second record, and I could sense from the music that I was listening to that the second album was going to be something so different, and we were going to do this whole 360 on what we did on the first record. So I was listening to a lot of, like, R&B music and pop. I'm a huge pop fan. I've always been a pop fan. I'm an 80s kid, so I think growing up with, like, Aaliyah and stuff like Boyz II Men, and I kind of knew that, oh, this is coming up. This is coming up in a songwriting way. And I would just tell myself I wasn't going to fight the idea. I was just going to let it roll and let it play out. And I think you hear a lot of those influences on the album. A lot of people say it is very pop. I guess it is pop, you know, if you want to box it into something. But to me, it's just a really feel-good album. Each track has a different genre and feel to it. Working with Fabian Singh, I met Fabian when I moved from Cape Town back up to Joburg, and I knew we started jamming together live, and we got on so well, and I went to his studio. He's got this beautiful studio at his house, and I started noticing how, like, talented Fabian was, you know, just not a guitarist. He was this crazy mad producer, and he had so much influence on this album, so much. Like, I wouldn't have been able to make this album without him. I came in with singer-songwriter tracks, and he would just change them up. And one of the tracks on the album, actually, Rich Man, was such a, like, Mumford and Sons kind of jing jigga jing 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 track. And he came aboard and he was like, well, you know, let's add these sounds and let's do this. And so I like I said, I wouldn't have been able to do it without him. I mean, I must be honest, I think, like any artist out there releasing that second album, you know, there's a lot of talk before the hand that, like, this album could make or break you, you know, this is your second album, and there was so much hype and the sales were so good, like, on the Dark Horse. And I think I put a lot of pressure on myself this time around, especially with the songwriting. And so I'm nervous not because I'm nervous to perform it, because I love performing and I consider myself being a performer, but I'm nervous because it is such a different sound, and either you're gonna walk this journey with me, or you might lose me in the middle a bit. But hopefully I've faith in my fans, and they'll walk this journey with me.
Yeah. Obsessed from the dark, paranoid, burn J's with a spark. Take all night if you start reminiscing the starlight. Fireworks indoors in a bar fight.
I guess it would be what the album means to me. And I wanted to make an album that I would buy, you know. And I made it, and I feel really good and very proud of it. And you know, I'm listening to the album at the moment in my car, because to be honest, I forgot most of my lyrics, so I have to do that. But listening to it, every time I listen to it, it makes me feel light, and it makes me feel good, and there are less sad songs on it. So I think what I want them to take away would be that light, you know, that like, oh, I get it, you know. So, yeah. I just want you, but I'm crazy. So I would describe this new sound, I keep going back to the title of it being light. Yes, it has a light sound. There's a bit of R&B in it. Some tracks definitely have that kind of pop feel to it. Obviously, any artist wouldn't like to box. You wouldn't like to box yourself, but it's. I actually had this person referred to being indie house, which I really liked. And so, I guess if you want to put that pop flavor to it, you could say it's indie pop house music. In a sense, that's my description of it. But I think mine is purely based on what I was listening to while I was making it. So, yeah, that's my description. I play the song to you somehow. I wanna go. The album is available on iTunes. It's titled Light, so please go out and buy it, and you'll be able to get it your hard copy, which I'm a hard copy kind of person, in any music or music moods or look and listen store near you. So yeah, go out and get it. Hey, this is Taylor at Music Connection here in Jersey City, and catch you at the next show.